Hi everyone.
You're not Santa.
What?
You're not Santa. You don't have a beard.
Well, I know I'm not Santa. It's just a hat.
Why do you have Santa's hat?
It's not Santa's hat. It's a hat like Santa has.
Is Santa's head cold now?
No, Santa's head isn't cold. We both have a hat.
Oh, okay. Well, as long as you're sure.
Right, where were we? Yes, hello, I'm Jeff.
And I'm Jim.
And we're the Puppet Pals.
Do you know why we're the Puppet Pals, Jeff?
Because we're puppets?
Because we're best pals.
Yes, how could I forget? Anyway.
You know, Jeff, we should be called the Puppet Best Pals.
You know, that doesn't have the same ring to it.
Ring? Who's got a ring?
As I was saying, because we couldn't have any Christmas parties this year, we are here to present the online Christmas party!
Yay! Party!
Now, before we start, as we always do at our Christmas parties, let's say a prayer. So boys and girls, mums and dads, let's all bow our heads and close our eyes to pray.
But we can't close our eyes, Jeff.
Well, I know that, but they can.
Oh, sorry.
Now settle down, Jim, okay? Dear Lord and Heavenly Father, we pray to you to thank you for keeping us safe through this past year. It's been a tough year and we are especially thankful you've stayed close to us. Some of us have lost people we love and some of us know people who are sick. And we pray that you will continue to comfort us when we are upset. We thank you for the internet so you can still have online fellowship and for the videos the church have been putting on YouTube. We ask that you will continue to look after us over Christmas and you will bring us all together again in the church kids group soon. We pray that your will be done, and we pray in your name alone. Amen.
Amen.
Let the Christmas tree remind you of the one who trusts the Lord, who walks the paths of godliness and loves to hear God's word. Pray that as you grow up, that's just how you will be. Standing tall for Jesus like a Christmas tree. Let your love show, ho, ho. Let your faith grow, ho, ho. That everyone will know Christ the King of Christmas. Well, let the fairy lights remind you of that bright and shining star, spotted by the wise men who traveled from afar. They gave Jesus all their treasures and they worshipped him that night. Let your worship of King Jesus shine like fairy lights. Let your love show, ho, ho. Let your faith grow, ho, ho. That everyone will know Christ the King of Christmas. Well, let the candy cane remind you of God's amazing grace. Red the blood of Jesus as he suffered in our place. White the full forgiveness won as Jesus rose again. You can tell your friends the gospel with a candy cane. Let your love show, ho, ho. Let your faith grow, ho, ho. That everyone will know Christ the King of Christmas. Well, let all the gifts at Christmas time fill your heart with praise to God for all his goodness shown in oh so many ways. That every day in every way would be completely his. Give your life to Jesus as a Christmas gift. Let your love show, ho, ho. Let your faith grow, ho, ho. That everyone will know. Let your love show, ho, ho. Let your faith grow, ho, ho. That everyone will know Christ the King of Christmas.
Oh, Jeff, I like that song. Do you like my singing?
Not really, Jim. I'll not tell a lie. You hurt my ears.
Well, I never said I was good at singing. I just said I liked singing.
Well, moving on. Next up, we have our Christmas challenge.
Another Christmas challenge?
What do you mean, another Christmas challenge? What's the other one?
This year, my Christmas challenge is to tie my own shoelaces.
And why is that a challenge, Jim?
Because I'm a puppet, Jeff. My fingers are stitched together.
Well, you've got a point there. Surely that's a challenge all year round and not just for Christmas.
You know what, Jeff? I never thought about it.
Okay, well, you have a think about that for a minute. We're going to take a look at the real Christmas challenge.
Hello, boys and girls. Hope you're all well and really excited for Christmas. We are going to learn a memory verse to help us see the real meaning of Christmas. This verse can be found in Titus chapter 2, verse 11. It says, "For the grace of God has appeared, bringing salvation for all people." We find Titus in the New Testament. It's a small book with just three chapters, but we are going to concentrate on Titus chapter 2, verse 11. This is part of a Christmas challenge that our minister has set for our congregations of Castle Dawson and Kern for Christmas morning. John would like us to memorize Titus chapter 2, verses 11 to 14, but we are going to concentrate just on verse 11. So we'll say it together after 2. 1, 2. The Bible says in Titus chapter 2, verse 11, "For the grace of God has appeared, bringing salvation for all people." This verse talks about the grace of God appearing, and we know that this is talking about Jesus coming into the world to be our Saviour. In other words, he came into the world, which we remember especially at this time of the year, as the one who saves us from our sins and gives us eternal life. This is the greatest gift we can ever receive, even better than all the toys and presents we will receive over Christmas time. This verse also tells us that it's available for everyone. So as you learn these verses for this Christmas challenge, or maybe just learn verse 11, I hope you remember that Jesus is the very best gift of all. Now, we'll say the verse through together after 2. 1, 2. The Bible says in Titus chapter 2, verse 11, "For the grace of God has appeared, bringing salvation for all people." Okay, we'll try and say the verse now, and we'll maybe remove a couple of the words and see how we get on. Okay, after 2, 1, 2. The Bible says in Titus chapter 2, verse 11, "For the grace of God has appeared, bringing salvation for all people." Okay, we'll try it maybe this time and leave out a couple extra words. Ready? After 2. 1, 2. The Bible says in Titus chapter 2, verse 11, "For the grace of God has appeared, bringing salvation for all people." Thank you, boys and girls, for doing the memory verse with me. We will say it just one more time. So after 2, 1, 2. The Bible says in Titus chapter 2, verse 11, "For the grace of God has appeared, bringing salvation for all people." I hope and pray that you remember that Jesus is our very best Christmas gift. And I hope you all have a happy Christmas.
Ooh, that's a fun challenge, Jeff.
I'm glad you think so, Jim. You should give it a go.
I think I might.
Good for you. Now, coming up next is a little video called God With Us, made by Faith in Kids.
Ooh, that sounds interesting.
It tells the story of the birth of baby Jesus using gingerbread people.
Oh, that sounds fun. Can we eat the gingerbread afterwards?
No, Jim, it's a video.
Aww.
After we watch the video, then we're going to play a game and hear the lesson.
But Jeff, I'm hungry for gingerbread.
Shh, the video's starting. Lights, camera, action.
On that first Christmas, Mary met God's messenger, who brought news of great joy.
You're having a baby boy!
On that first Christmas, Joseph was in meltdown. All his plans were wrecked. He was feeling super stressed. He was just about to snap.
Oh dear, looks like he has.
The child's not his. It's all too much. When word gets out, there'll be such drama. So, chopping wood helps him feel calmer. Joseph plans to walk away. What on earth would make him stay? He heads off to hit the hay, and as he sleeps, God speaks.
Joseph, don't be afraid to take Mary as your wife. The baby in her is from the Holy Spirit.
Good news for a heart that was filled with fear. Good news of Emmanuel. God, come near.
She will have a son, and they will name him Emmanuel. This name means God is with us.
Joseph got up, and Joseph went on. Together they witnessed the birth of God's son.
God's with us,
they whispered while holding him tight. He's come into our chaos and into our night. For those now in meltdown whose plans have been wrecked. For all who are feeling tired and stressed. For anyone who's ready to snap and everyone that's in a flap. This is the good news we all need to hear. God is with us, right now, and right here. This Christmas time, please don't walk away. For God is with us, and He came to stay. We can get up, and we can go on, held tight by our Saviour, Jesus, God's Son.
Emmanuel. His name means God is with us.
Merry Christmas, boys and girls. Now, I have a question. Does anybody know what the first six letters in the word Christmas spell? I'll give you a clue. It's a name of somebody really, really important in the Christmas story. Anybody know? Christ. Jesus Christ, the Saviour of the world who was born at Christmas. So when we say Merry Christmas to people, we're really saying the name of Christ, because Christmas is all about Jesus Christ and the start of his rescue plan. Now, tonight's our Christmas party, and no Christmas party would be complete without a game to play. So we're going to play a guessing game. Get your thinking caps on, boys and girls. I've got a box full of some of my favourite Christmas decorations. And in this box, I've got quite a few different decorations, which I will show you. And what you have to do is I'm going to take one out, and you have to see if you can guess which one I've taken out of my box. So I'll show you what I've got. I've got an angel in the box. I have got a yummy candy cane. Anybody like those? I've got a snowman who usually hangs in the tree. And actually, in fact, I do actually have a Christmas tree as well in there. Now let's see. I've got a present. Okay, if you're wondering what to get your grannies for Christmas, you'll get in her good books if you get her some of that Chanel. There. Now, and of course, no Christmas tree would be complete without Christmas lights. Christmas lights. So I've got them all back in my box. And boys and girls, I'll give you a last look. Okay, some of them are rattling about there. Hopefully you can see the angel, the snowman, the tree, the star, the present. Okay, lock them all in your brain. Okay. Now I'm going to take one out and then you've got a chance to look and see if you can tell me what it is.
Okay, boys and girls, I've taken one thing out of the box. Can you guess what it is? What's missing?
Have you guessed what's missing? Here it is. It was the angel that was missing. Now, angels are so important at the first Christmas because angels were the ones to come to the shepherd on the hillside and tell them the good news that finally, finally, the baby Jesus, the saviour they'd been waiting for, had been born. Well done if you spotted the angel. Now let's put the angel back in. Okay, to make it difficult. And I will take out another one. Little pig. What am I going to take out this time?
Okay, boys and girls, what's missing this time? What have I taken out of the box?
Well, did you guess what it was this time? Any guesses? Shout it out. Well done to use those who knew that it was the gift I'd taken out, the gift that every granny wants. Now, at Christmas time, we love getting gifts and we love giving gifts as well. But do you know who gave the first Christmas gift? It was God. The Bible says that God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whosoever believed in him shall not perish, but shall have everlasting life. There are two gifts in that verse. Did you hear them? God gave his only Son, Jesus. And if we believe in Jesus, then we get given another gift. We are given the gift of eternal life in Jesus Christ. Let's put the gift back in. Another little look. Little peek. And I'll take something else out.
Okay, that's the second thing taken out of the box. So what is missing this time? Not the tree, not the lights. What's missing?
Have you guessed what it is this time? I wonder who's got it right. It was the star. God was so excited when Jesus was born that he didn't just send choirs of angels to tell the shepherds. No, he actually put a star in the sky. And the wise men, they saw that star and they followed that star all the way to Jesus. And this Christmas, boys and girls, we want you to be like the wise men. The wise men found Jesus and they worshipped him. It changed their lives forever. This Christmas, we want you to find Jesus, to follow him, to give your life to him, to be completely changed by Jesus. Well done if you guessed the star. Put it back in. Okay, you ready for me to take something else out?
What's missing this time? Can anybody guess? Wonder who knows already.
Did you see what was missing? I'll give you a clue. It was green and there's one behind me. The Christmas tree. That's right. You see, the Christmas tree reminds us of some things about God. The Christmas trees are always green. They're always this kind of fir tree. And it's an evergreen. It never loses its leaves and it never really changes. And you see, that reminds us a little bit what God is like, because God never changes. No, he never does. But the other thing our trees can remind us of is something that Jesus did when Jesus grew up. Because Jesus died on a cross, and sometimes we call that cross a tree. Jesus died at the tree of Calvary and he did it so that you and I could have that gift of eternal life if we say sorry for our sins. Well done if you guessed the tree that time. Right, I'll pop it back in. We've got a few more things in the box, little glue. In. What's it going to be this time?
Okay, you are getting really good at this. The tree's back in. But who or what is missing?
Okay, who guessed it this time? Shout it out. Well done if you realised it was Mr. Snowman. Now, wouldn't it be great if we had a white, snowy Christmas this year? Do you know, the Bible tells us that even though our sins are as dark red scarlet, Jesus can wash them clean, as white as snow, it says. So we can have any sin forgiven, any sin washed away, and we can be as white and as pure as snow. Wouldn't that be great, boys and girls? Well done, if you got my friend the snowman. Pop him back in. Ready for the next one?
What could it be this time? What have I taken out of the box? They're doing so well in this game. Just two more guesses.
Are we still thinking? Have you got what it is yet? Okay, shout it out when you're ready. I'll give you a clue. It's just a little bit darker in the box without these. Yes, you've got it. It is the Christmas lights. Now, I love the Christmas lights. And if you walk around Castle Dawson and Curran, you will see Christmas lights everywhere. And it's beautiful in the darkness. Now, Jesus said about himself that he is the light of the world. And anyone who follows him will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. And that's a really exciting thing. You see, not only is Jesus the light, and we can run to that light, but we can also then be little lights, little stars, shining for Jesus Christ, wherever we are, in school, with your family, with your friends, you can be a light shining for Jesus. So well done if you got my lights. Well done, boys and girls. We've done really well. I think there's just one more. Okay, so keep thinking. I'm going to take it out.
What's missing this time? Shout it out if you know already.
Okay, last one. What do you think it is? Yeah, really tasty one. That's right. It's the candy cane. Now, I wonder what this can teach us about Jesus. It tastes really good, but what does it say about the Christ of Christmas? Well, I've got some friends who are going to tell us a little poem now about the candy cane. So have a listen up and you'll see some of your friends telling you about this wonderful sweet at Christmas. Bye!
Look at the candy cane. What do you see? Stripes that are red, like Jesus' blood was shed for me.
White is for my Saviour, who is sinless and pure. J is for Jesus, my Lord, that's for sure.
Turn around,
and the staff you will see,
Jesus my Shepherd,
was born for me.
Okay, boys and girls, now it's time to sing Away in a Manger.
Oh, Jeff, I love this one. Away in a manger, no crib for a bed. The little Lord
that's
Jesus,
not the tune.
Laid down his sweet head.
That works surprisingly well.
The stars in the bright sky looked down.
Jim!
What?
Let's just sing it to the proper tune, shall we?
That's not the proper tune?
No!
Oh, I've always wondered why I got kicked out of the Christmas choir.
Down where he lay,
boys and girls, that's all we have time for this year.
It's been different, but fun, Jeff.
Yes, it has, Jim. And we want to thank everyone for joining in with us, and for anyone who gave a helping hand with us today, and for preparing videos throughout the year.
You know something, Jeff? Sometimes I think if I didn't have a helping hand, I couldn't get out of bed in the morning.
Jim, you never cease to amaze me.
Ah, thanks, Jeff.
That wasn't a compliment. Anyway, goodbye, folks.
Goodbye, everyone. Jeff?
Yes?
Have you ever noticed we can only use one hand when we're talking?
Happy Christmas, everyone, from all the leaders at Good News Club.
Hello, we would just like to say Happy Christmas from Girls Brigade.
Happy Christmas!
Happy Christmas from Sunday School.
Hi boys and girls, I just wanted to wish you a very happy Christmas from all the leaders at the Good News Club.
And all the leaders at BB as well, I just want to wish you all a very happy Christmas.
Boys and girls, happy Christmas from all the church family in Curran and Castle Dawson.